thank you for tuning in. On this video, we're gonna be discussing the Rolex GMT in yellow gold with the green dial. So the first thing I wanna say is obviously the green dial is what makes it hot. I feel like nowadays, everything that has green or blue is flying off the shelf. The demand is so high that the prices are going crazy. But the crazy part about this is that, man, I remember 6-7 years ago, the green dial wasn't for everybody. People would come and look at it, they try it on and they say, I don't like the green dial. I can't match it with my clothes. I mean, do you think I think about that every time that I'm gonna wear something like this? About what's gonna match and not gonna match? I mean, some people are like that, I understand it. But 6 or 7 years ago, the green was just a little bit too much for some buyers. This watch was even as low as $17,000 to $18,000. I always love to use the stainless steel Daytona as a reference because they're so high right now. But at that time, the Daytonas were going for $9,000. Crazy part about it is now, who would have known? We should have known. It should have been obvious that the anniversary dial on the GMT was gonna be the next big hit from that lineup. This particular watch that I have right now on my wrist happens to be a 2011, which pretty much means that somebody would have had to have bought it at retail, okay, 10 years ago, held on to it that long knowing that it was gonna be the next best thing, to obviously turn such a profit and say, hey, look what I have now. Because along that time, prices did go down, prices went up. But the question is, a lot of people ask me, they say, hey Eric, what's gonna be the next collector watch? And it's like, look, I wish I knew. I would have bought all of them right now as well. The Daytona green dial seems to be an obvious go. Yes, not only because John Mayer said it would be, but because it has a green dial. History will repeat itself over and over. Look, you have the Hulk, you had the GMT green dial. So it would only make sense that the Daytona with the green dial, and perhaps even the Day-Date green dial, is gonna be the next best thing. But other than that, I love this watch. I mean, it's a sports model in yellow gold. You know, I'm a sucker for all of the Rolex sports models. They always fit good, look good, they're good for any occasion. So this is the type of watch you can wear for just pretty much about anything. Doesn't matter if you're wearing a nice dressy outfit or on the beach sand with some shorts. It's always gonna be right for the occasion. And the green dial for me is what just gives it that extra pop that just makes it stand out instead of the standard black on black that you will mostly see on everybody else. So if you haven't subscribed already to my new channel, go ahead and hit that button now and don't miss out on any of the new content. So another thing I wanna point out, a lot of people ask me, say, how do you know that the dial hasn't been replaced? I mean, look, you never really know. Some people feel that these watches get out of a magic goose already assembled. They don't realize that these watches are hand assembled. So yes, somebody can change a dial and it'll be exactly like it came from the factory. However, there are a couple little things that I use on this model to know if it originally came with the dial. Number one is the second time zone hand, the long needle with the triangle on top. On the black dial version, that hand will usually come painted green. So if that hand was painted green and it was on top of this dial, it wouldn't have any contrast. So that's one easy first way to see. Another thing would be the actual date wheel. On the black dial version, they usually come with the green number font. Again, for that contrast. So if you have a green dial on your yellow GMT and you have a green 24-hour hand and a green date wheel, there's a possibility that the dial was swapped. I mean, unless they swap the hands and also change the date wheel, but at that point, how the hell are we supposed to know? I mean, at the end of the day, if they didn't do a good job, the person that replaced it, I would be able to know, me. But if someone did a flawless job and changed everything, then what difference does it make? It's correct. Right now, as I stand here, the green on this dial just completely pops. I don't even know if maybe perhaps where the camera is right now, if you could just see it piercing and jumping off my wrist. That's just the effect that that green dial gives. One thing I've always wanted to say is, I'm not really sure why they didn't use this exact green dial color on many other watches. It just would have been nice to have seen it on perhaps another model. You know, the Hulk dial is nice, but this one with that non-metallic, non-translucent, just kind of like a true flat green, just really looks stunning. And for me, I've just always liked this watch. And I'm gonna go ahead and admit right now that I do regret never buying one of these watches when they were that low. But then again, who knew? Right now, they are way over where they used to be. To pick up a watch like this nowadays, you gotta have a solid 35,000 if you think you're gonna get one. You know, I feel like the watch is worth it, but I don't know, you get over that hump where you're thinking, man, I should have bought them when they were a lot lower, because at least in my collection, this would be a watch that would definitely accent completely. The Submariner with the blue dial is a classic and looks stunning. And yes, of course, the GMT with black also looks nice, but the green one completely pops, and it's what separates, in my opinion, the Submariner from the GMT without any confusion to both the knowledgeable and the guys that are just starting. So this GMT reference number 116718 originally had a retail price of $33,250. On the grand scope of things now, considering that to get a brand new one, you're gonna probably have to spend 40 grand, it doesn't sound too bad. It really doesn't. Now the way that the market is with everything so inflated, I don't really like to use the word inflated because for me it sounds like it's a bunch of bullshit. I just think that nowadays there's so much exposure on the watch hobby and the fact that if you buy them correctly, they're good investments, that there is a big demand of people new into the hobby and wanting to buy them. And the fact of the matter is there just isn't enough of them to go around. That compounded with the fact that manufacturers are clamping down on production to increase this even more, makes me really feel like an idiot that I could have had them at $18,000 and I didn't buy one. I remember I sold one to my friend for $23,000 about 6 years ago, brand new. He went ahead and wore it for close to 5 years, made like four tours in South Beach with that watch, and still sold it for a profit. And even then now, both me and him feel that perhaps we should have kept it. So if you're looking to buy one of these watches, you're probably gonna be for sure in the over $35,000 range. And I personally believe that this is a true collector watch. And only as time passes by more and more is where people will realize how rare it really will become. I guess I fall into the whole Rolex fanboy trap where green and blue is the way to go. I tell you what, I always, always liked the green dial from the beginning. None of that from later on. I'm talking about from the beginning, off rip, I always liked it. People always came and told me that, you know, that they didn't like the green. Oh, because I don't like green. I always felt that I like green. As corny as it sounds, you know, green for me, I always think about money. Even though nowadays, $100 are blue. In the watch game, this watch has obviously recently gained more strength. Whereas maybe perhaps 4 or 5 years ago, yes, it was a nice watch. You were still maybe getting bullied by some other models. Now with the recent increase in price, obviously it has raised a bit more stature in the game. So if you got one, hold on to it tight. It was a sleeper. So if you've slept on it, nap time is over because now it's becoming very, very hard to get it. I mean, unless you want to go to eBay and pay those insane prices. So if you found this video useful or entertaining, go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button now.